Box. So the sporadic artillery fire, but as yet, no real contact. But it looks as though the Allies' advance has certainly slowed down for a few moments. They're probably radioing back for reinforcements. The Allies were so well camouflaged, I didn't even know they were down at the bottom end of the arena. So they've opened fire on the advancing German troops. Germans are waiting for the order to advance. Bang goes the neighbourhood. Still sporadic mortar fire coming in. Artillery fire. Infantry is advancing slowly. They have the advantage that they have the higher ground, so they're looking down on their feet. There's a nice smoke ring above us in the sky. Seems to be a little bit of a stalemate at the moment. The Allies have called in some heavy armour. The Germans have recognised the stretch of the Allied armour. It's producing. You can see just then how maneuverable the M18 is, the way it managed to turn, did that U-turn for such a short stretch. And if it isn't hot enough, we've got the explosions all around us. Here we go again. Straight out of the right side there. And the Germans have called in some of their tank destroyer units. So the most important thing now is for the German soldiers to get out of the way of the armoured vehicles which are coming in, because the driver has very limited visibility. Obviously you don't want to drive over your own people, and we don't want to drive over any reenactors, so we want to keep casualties and everything else to the minimum. The Germans are also on the top of the hill. They're bringing some mounting cannons, some 75mm cannons up in their artillery units. The M36 has joined the battle, as have the M16 half track. Well, the Stugs are coming down now. These are very, very effective anti-tank weapons. They're very, very low down, squat vehicles, very cheap to manufacture. They can carry a more powerful gun than a tank of the same size. Very, very high kill rate these vehicles had. I think it's a